to the channel. Thank you guys for being here. So I don't know who this reading is going to be for yet, but I will tell you the music that came through was Only God Knows Why by Kid Rock, and it was a live version he was singing with Jamie Johnson. Beautiful version. And in that song he says, how does he say it? He says, people get what they deserve. You put in, and then you get back out what you deserve. But I haven't seen mine. So it's like, you've been putting a lot in, but you haven't been getting anything back. And people don't really know you, but they want to pretend like they do because you're somebody who is considered famous or semi-famous, or a lot of people know you. I'll put it like that. But they don't know you. They don't know, at your core, they don't have a clue who you are. The other song that came through was What Am I to You by Nora Jones. And she says, if my sky should fall, would you even call? So tell me, darling, true, what am I to you? I'm giving you the ball. Ball's in your court. So I don't know who this is for. First thing I want to do is find out the energy of the person that I'm reading for. Spirit, could you please guide me? Could you please move me out of the way? Use whatever gifts you've given me, whatever abilities you've given me, to help me read. Wow, so somebody's very spiritual here. We have a camel and a golden egg. A camel and a lizard. This could be for Sagittarius. A lizard and a swan. The other day, Mary's daughter was walking the dog, and the neighbor stopped her and said, do you know if there's anything going on at your mom's house with the girl that lives with her? And Meg was like, what do you mean? And she said, well, a lot of us have noticed when we walk by this house that we feel this strange feeling, like she had a retractable leash, and she said, like, the sound of this leash when it retracts, it feels like something flies by our head, and it's like that leash when it retracts. Well, immediately it sounded to me like she was feeling the vibes. There's a vibe, and all of us have vibrations. And I think that whoever it is feeling the vibrations coming off of my readings and the ancestors, the guides, and angels that are around Miss Mary and I, because they are a lot, and they like to play tricks, they like to be funny, they do a lot of things, they're mischievous a lot of times. But she and I are used to it, so we don't pay it any mind. But she said that the next door neighbor, that his garage door keeps opening on its own, and the trunk of his car keeps doing the same thing. And he's had a check to see what's wrong with it, and they say nothing. So he doesn't understand why his garage door keeps opening and why the trunk of his car keeps opening. And I don't know either. It may not even be related to what's going on here. But I know one night I was doing a private reading with a friend of mine. And she and I have both, when we get together, it's like our spirit guides go off. They throw a party. They have a blast. And I have a tendency to cause the lights to flicker when I'm in a room. And I can move from one light to another, and it'll do it for each light that I'm around. Miss Mary's seen it happen. A couple people who have been here visiting have seen it happen. It doesn't always happen, but it does happen. And that night, she and I were doing that reading, and the reading got very intense. And the lights my equipment went out, and then the next thing I know, I was telling her, I was like, the lights on my camera equipment just went out. And I said, I'll be damned. I said, the whole neighborhood just blacked out. And the whole neighborhood was blacked out. And then the next day, I was asking around, trying to find out what was wrong. Because the lights didn't come back on. We were doing that reading at like 10 in the evening, 10 p.m. And the lights didn't come on until after 2:30 in the morning. And they were out there looking for the reason all that time. And they finally found that the reason was right behind this house where I'm living. There was something that, there was some kind of, what do you call it? There was not a breaker, but transmitter, I think is what they call it. So anyway, paranormal stuff is normal for me, but not for the people around me. And Meg said, well, you know, she's psychic or something like that. And the lady said, yeah, we know, because one of the girls that had lived here, not lived here, but had stayed here helping with Miss Mary, was here during a time when some weird stuff happened. And she told them. That's how the neighbors found out. So now the neighbors know about me and about my spiritual stuff. But they found out primarily because she told them, but they are experiencing paranormal stuff in their homes and feel the vibes when they walk by the house. I just thought that was so funny. Alright, Spirit, talk to me. Show me the energy of the people, the group of people that we're reading for. May I see, please? What is their energy right now? Show me their energy right now. Put your answers on, please. May I see their energy? There we go. You're a sea serpent. You're very spiritual. And an owl. You're also very wise. Very rare person. Wow. I want to tell you exactly what this means. You're somebody special. I can tell you that right now. Somebody very special. Sea serpent. That's one of the most spiritual cards in this deck. There's only three or four of them in here, and you showed up as a sea serpent. Male, where is the sea serpent? Must be the first one. There we go. The sea serpent. The sea serpent. Healing emotional wounds, expressing desires. The sea serpent represents the energy of expression, whether it's emotions, creativity, sensuality, or desire. The sea serpent helps us move and direct our energy into a healthy current. When the essence of this card is in balance, we express ourselves creatively and sexually without fear or shame. We know what we desire most. Our hearts are at ease and our relationships are meaningful and enduring. We loosen the grip of self-judgment and we let the cool waters of forgiveness in to heal our wounds. When the energy of the sea serpent is not yet activated, and yours did come out in reverse, so it has not yet been activated, our emotions and creativity are left in the muddy waters. The current of expression stagnates in some areas of our lives, and in other places it floods. It's important to remember, no matter what the waters of our emotional lives look like, the sea serpent loves us just the same. Like a mother, she wraps herself around us in a gesture of protection. She supports us as we learn to express our true nature. The sea serpent and the second chakra. The subtle energy of the sea serpent occupies the area of the Vajrasattana chakra, located deep within the pelvic bowl. This chakra is known as our center of creativity and desire, and is associated with the water element. Vajrasattana translates as in her own abode, indicating this chakra is the home of the Divine Mother, or Kundalini herself. So you're going through the Kundalini awakening, or you're about to. I think you're about to have the Kundalini awakening begin in your life. I think that's what's being said here. It hasn't begun yet. You're on the verge of it. It may have already been activated because it kind of came out sideways. I'm looking for the owl. But the awakening is intense, and you may want to join some groups on Facebook to help you understand what you're going through, because you can have some very strong symptoms, a lot of very paranormal stuff. That's why I was telling you about the paranormal stuff, because I have gone through this awakening and still am going through this awakening. The owl is abundance, clairvoyance, and treasures. The owl is a mysterious and otherworldly creature found in folklore from east to west. The white owl in this particular deck is the companion of the goddess Lakshmi and represents wealth, beauty, and good fortune. When the owl card appears, it's an omen that a boon or treasure is on the way, either in spiritual or material form. With owl wisdom on your side, you'll see and know exactly what to do with the boon, how it can further serve your dharma. Your dharma is your good karma. Remember I said I've given and people get what they deserve, but I ain't seen mine. You're fixing to see yours, and you'll know how it can further serve your dharma and bring abundance to the world. Trust that the wellspring of treasures is infinite. So when you start to see this wellspring of abundance coming into your life, don't panic and try and put it away and hoard it. Continue to put it out into the world and use it to do good in the world, because it's an endless supply. It never ends. It's infinite. When in balance, you're generous, trusting, and secure. When out of balance, you have quarrels over money, and you feel like there's scarcity, like a scarcity mindset. To bring it into balance, make an offering. In other words, give something, expecting nothing in return. Or do something like make a money altar. See my money tree? It is so hard to grow a money tree. And our money tree, I don't know if you can see it or not, is thriving. Let me see if I can see the money tree, how it's thriving. It's huge. You know how hard it is to get a money tree to stay alive, much less thrive? And I had to repot it. You have to repot it. You're supposed to do it with special soil, but I just used what I had, and it still is thriving, and I'm so grateful. Thank you, Spirit, for helping me with this money tree, because it represents the abundance of our collective, and we are abundant. All right, use the black deck I'm hearing to get overall tarot here. What's the overall tarot, Spirit? There's a bonus card here. The Lovers is here. There's a Gemini feel here. Libra, Justice, and the Fool with the Hermit. So the way Spirit's working is somebody is making a choice to see the truth and to take their soul searching about taking a risk. death on the bottom of the deck. All right, what's the energy to overcome? You have a lot going on, a lot of major stuff. There's something that you're having a hard time ending, and you're stuck here. You're stuck because there's something that just will not end. That's the energy to overcome, is thinking that this is never going to end. All right, what's going to pull it together? You feel like there's something in your life that's just never going to stop, never going to end. You're going to always be stuck here. What's going to pull it together? Perfect card, huh, Spirit? What's going to pull it together? Somebody's going to lose their patience, and they're going to overcome this. They're going to dig deep and get over this. They might even actually get in a car or go somewhere. And therein lies the transformation. Scorpio is here. Taurus is here. Sagittarius is here. Taurus is here again. Virgo is here. Aries is here. Libra and Gemini are here. And these are very spiritual people who have given a lot of themselves. You have sacrificed a lot, and you're about to get your abundance back. If you feel like you're not, Spirit wants you to make a sacrifice. Spirit wants you to make a money altar of some sort, a way to acknowledge that you're struggling in this and you need help from the divine when it comes to your dharma, your good karma. All right, let's see what energy oracle. Spirit said find out who I'm reading for first. Okay. Who is this spirit that I'm reading for? May we see, please, who this is? Sagittarius, it's you, baby. Welcome back to the channel. All right, let's see what the energy oracle would say about your situation. Energy oracle, what would you say about this situation Sagittarius is in? Your blossoming abundance is here with your second chakra. I can't make this shit up. Exactly what I just read to you about the owl and the sea serpent. The door to romance is here with your second chakra. So there's a relationship that you have a desire for also. Or you desire to have somebody to be a partner for you in life. To be the sun is here with the door to romance. Some of you might be happy being alone. All right, message please for Sagittarius. There's a woman holding the heart, Sagittarius, and the magician in the mirror. A woman holding a heart. Somehow there's a woman that's holding a heart. This woman is attached to your heart. They are somehow attached to your love. Okay, number 44 is significant. And then we have the magician in the mirror. The magician in the mirror is the magician, which is actually what we have. I saw him somewhere. Where did I see him? Maybe I didn't. Why am I seeing things? So, I want to read you what's being said here. Number 44 is the woman connected to your money. Woman holding a heart. A female dealing with family, love, or emotions. The woman on this card wears a butterfly in her hair and holds a lovely large heart in her hands. For a woman, this card upright could be a reflection of your own state of peaceful emotion and receptivity for love. Or it might be a message that your family issues are going to resolve. You're an intuitive woman who understands the emotions of life, and you're bringing that awareness to all that you do. This card upright could also indicate the presence of a female friend, teacher, or confidant who's here to help with issues of love, family, or emotion. This is an even-tempered and caring person who resonates with you and your emotions. This could also portend a new love interest or a friend coming your way. So, this woman may be you, and you may have somebody new coming your way, or you could have family issues that are being resolved. Take it as it resonates for your situation. There's a woman holding a heart. And then number 53, the Magician in the Mirror. Knowing and using your true power. This card upright represents the culmination of your personal and spiritual power at this time. In the Magician's left hand is a flame of passion and action. In his right hand is a vortex of water and the light of reflection. This highly beneficial card is letting you know you are the Magician, and within your grasp are the amazing forces of earth and spirit. The water is the energy of your power of spirit and clarity of thought. The flame is the energy of yang, bringing direction and creativity. Together, they give you the magnificent magic or transformation. The mirror stands beside the Magician, reflecting the outer world's response to your choice to use or dismiss this true power that you have. Its silver reflection reveals the future in a mist on the horizon, ready to be magically formed. When you receive the Magician upright, you are put on notice that an important and powerful time is at hand. You are the alchemist of your life, and just as the alchemist turns base metal into gold, you are now able to transform your difficulties into great blessings. This is true in every area of your life. Claim your power and embrace your intentions in your heart and in your daily life. Direct your destiny, and the mist of the future will clear into brilliant reality. So you're manifesting your reality, and you're going to get your dharma. You're going to get your karma that is good. You're going to get your dharma. Your dharma is coming, Sagittarius. Your dharma is coming. Let's see what that might look like. Let's ask the Sacred Destiny. What does Sagittarius's dharma look like? Sacred Destiny, may I see, please? What is it that Sagittarius has on the horizon? What is on the horizon for Sagittarius? There's a woman holding a heart that's here to help you. You're going to take action to be in flow. You're going to take action that's going to put you in flow. Or you're already in flow and you're going to take action. Flow and opportunity. There's an opportunity that's going to flow to you. You're going to have pleasure and an opportunity. You're going to have an opportunity that's going to bring you a lot of pleasure, Sagittarius. Message for Sagittarius, please, Spirit. May I get a good, strong message for Sagittarius. Good, strong answers only, please. No fluffy-duffy today. Good, strong answers for Sagittarius about what's coming in their dharma. Courage came out for you, Sagittarius. I can't hold on to it. Courage. You're going to have courage. But, look what's happening. You have to have courage to believe in the miracles that are about to happen in your life. You are about to have some amazing things happen in your life. Miracles are about to happen for you. I want to take the good tarot. We're going to look at this when we go to work. And I want to see what's happening. Because everything is going to be good. You're about to have... You've been giving. And for a long time, you've been giving and getting not much in return. But you're about to reap the reward. There you are. Patience in the High Priestess. You are a patient High Priestess. You know the secret knowledge of the universe. You've been given blessings of secret knowledge. Seven of Wands in the High Priestess. So, you're not going to conform to patterns in this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind when it comes to God's Word. There's a King of Cups and a High Priestess. You could be a Cancer. Alright, we have Gemini here, the Lovers. Why is the Lovers here for Sagittarius Spirit? That's Gemini. Because of Gemini, Gemini is soul searching about what's true and taking risk. So we have a masculine Gemini here. That doesn't mean they're male, it just means their masculine energy is showing up. But they could be a male. Take it as it resonates. This person may have a Virgo placement also. This could be their ascending sign as well. What is it that they're soul searching about when it comes to justice and the Fool? An Eight of Swords, imprisonment. A feeling of... This picture has the feeling of somebody who's longing to get out of a situation. Clarify the Fool. Wish fulfilled. Clarify the Fool, please. They're soul searching about justice and the Fool. They want out of a situation that's made them have a lot of anxiety. Look, there's an Ace of Cups, and there you are, Sagittarius. This is about you getting out of a situation that makes you feel like you're in prison so you can have a new love. And there's a Gemini who is soul searching about this. There's a Gemini who wants out of a situation that makes them feel in prison so they can have a new love with a Sagittarius. Why is the World here? Because of the Five of Wands, the Four of Cups, the Page of Cups, the Two of Cups, the Chariot, and the Hierophant. So, the energy to overcome is there's something that's not ending, and it's like somebody's been fighting their feelings, and they won't take love. It's a friend, but they're in love, and they are coming to see you about a higher level commitment. They're going to come and see you and talk to you about a higher level commitment. What do they want to say about this higher level commitment, Spirit? Use the other deck I'm hearing. Queen of Wands on the bottom of the deck. What does this Gemini want to say to Sagittarius about this higher level commitment? Let me see, please. What does the Gemini want to say to the Sagittarius? They want to tell you, I'm unavailable. Someone or something is standing between us right now. But the answer is yes. That's what the Gemini wants to tell you. They want to tell you that the answer is yes to this higher level commitment. Yes, I do want to have a relationship with you. But right now, there's someone or something making me unavailable or making you unavailable. There's a mountain we have to climb because right now I'm taken and in the very near future. The answer is going to be yes, in the very near future, Gemini says. What would Sagittarius say back? I'm sweeping away toxicity to make room for what's truly important. And my life is falling apart and I'm struggling. So, Sagittarius, you have baggage and you're trying to get rid of some toxicity that you've been having to deal with. Anything else, Sagittarius, with Jay? I have a hard time trusting anyone. Please accept my apology so we can move past this. And I have so much going on in my life and I'm struggling to juggle it all at once with I need to take a step back because I'm still trying to figure out what I want. So the Gemini is unavailable, but they're going to tell you yes in the very near future. And you're getting rid of some toxicity. You have a hard time trusting anyone. You're doing fine by yourself. Please accept my apology and let's move past this. So you feel like you've done something wrong. And I have so much going on in my life. I'm struggling to juggle it all. And I just need to take a step back because I'm still trying to figure out what I want. So you don't even know what you want anymore when it comes to this relationship. I think you've waited for so long for this that you have kind of decided that it's not going to happen. And now that it is happening, the energy to overcome for you when it comes to this wheel is that somebody has been fighting their feelings, refusing to take love. It was a friend, or there's going to be a surprise that this person is going to say to you, Sagittarius, I want to be with you. I want to be with you, and I'm coming to see you to talk to you about being in a commitment, a higher level relationship. And they're going to tell you that there's somebody or someone standing in your way right now, and it could be a Leo because there's a Queen of Wands on the bottom of the deck. All right, why is Temperance in reverse? Because the Eight of Cups, the Page of Wands, the Ace of Pentacles, the Two of Swords, the Ten of Swords, the Six of Cups, and the Messenger of Air. So, Temperance. What you've lost your patience about is somebody walking away from something that no longer serves them and getting an exciting message about somebody wanting to have a new opportunity, an Ace of Pentacles. Because of being in denial about something that's over, having a lot of memories, but there's a truth that needs to come in real suddenly. Clarify the Messenger of Air. This is what's going to make you happy. Is a relationship. Somebody's going to come in real fast and say, you know what? You know what would make me happy is if I could have a relationship with you. And I want to get to you so badly. But I am having to move really slow because I've been at a crossroads. Why is the Two of Wands here? Because of the Three of Pentacles. Why is the Three of Pentacles here? This is about work. This person might not have a job because there's been deception. There's deception ending when it comes to a third party. Alright, why is death here? Because of somebody feeling like they've been left out in the cold when it comes to work, having balance, and being tempted. What do you mean, the devil? Why is Capricorn here, the devil? Temptation. The temptation is about reevaluating something that's kept them up at night. The lovers having a calling on their life and moving beyond this. I want to get past this. I keep looking back at all the anxiety, all the sleepless nights, the choices that I've made. And now I know I have a calling on my life and it's time for me to move past this. I'm tempted to just do this. That's what I'm tempted to do. And I have to stop deceiving myself into thinking that I don't, that this isn't for me. The Three of Swords, the Heartache is on the bottom of the deck. Why is death here? Because of the Ten of Wands, the Moon, and the King of Wands. So, this person is, the transformation is a Leo that's ending because of some real heavy shit. Look, there's the Queen of Wands. So, for some of you, it may be the feminine. For some of you, it may be the masculine Leo. Clarify the Moon energy. This person's tired of being in Moon energy. They're healing from some dark shit that happened. Clarify the Four of Swords. This is what's being manifested as healing. Somebody is manifesting healing. And that's why they're going to be willing to take a risk. What's going to be the outcome here of all of what I'm seeing on the table? Somebody's going to spy, and there's going to be an argument. Why is there going to be an argument? Because somebody wants to take a risk. They're tired of being in this relationship, and they're ready to start something new. And what's going to happen with this fool? This person who's stuck, this Virgo, that's soul searching, this Gemini, the one that's stuck, they're going to be a King of Pentacles because they're going to bring balance back into their life. They're going to be abundant. And they're carefully choosing how to do this. They're coming up with a plan of how to do this. Alright. So, let's just see if we can find out a little bit about how this happened. How did this happen to Sagittarius spirit? May we see, please? You had to agree to disagree. Alright. Well, what was being hidden? It says you were arguing with somebody and you had to always agree to disagree. Let your friends miss your face and just say those five little words. Your friends miss your face. Alright, what's being shown? That's what's being hidden, is that you've been talking to your friends and they miss you. What's being shown? That somebody's going to forgive, deal with their drama. Open their mouth, bare their fucking soul, and check themselves. Why are they going to check themselves? Fuck your job.
Going back on the porch.
Okay, it has to do with a job. Alright, what's going to happen next? Somebody's going to tell you to shut the fuck up, you're not being heard, and your boundaries are trash. Ooh. And somebody's going to send a picture, and it's time for shit to get real. I'm thinking there's some shit going down here, Sagittarius. There's about to be an argument. It looks like between a Gemini and a Leo, or a Leo and a Sagittarius. Or a Virgo, any of these signs could be at play here when it comes to this. But there's an argument. And somebody is going to say, you just need to shut the fuck up. Nobody's listening to you. You have shit for boundaries. And you've been sending pictures. What's this person's response going to be to that? There's a secret love. You go first. You know where I'm at. I'm not going anywhere. I'm not making a move. You know where to find me in a secret love. Alright, what's being hidden? That it's only you, this person is incomparable, and this was unintentional. What's being shown? That somebody's been online dating and they're haunted. And what's going to happen next? Somebody's going to realize, I love you. I love you more than I've ever loved anyone or ever found the words to say to you. And I want my freedom. Why are they online dating and haunted? Because somebody forever changed their life without even trying. They've had a lot of drama and they felt helpless. But they're healing. They're healing now. Thought I saw another card. But somebody's deciding they're going to heal. Because somebody forever changed their life. I guess they're going to quit online dating. Because it's causing drama. Because they feel helpless. What's going to be the outcome besides I love you? I'm going to have freedom because I am getting a divorce. I'm going to have freedom because I'm getting a divorce. Because I can't move on because I'm married to somebody else and I want to be with you and only you. That's what's going on here, Sagittarius. What's going on with the masculine here? Somebody feels like a victim. What's going on with the feminine here? They are amused. They amuse people. Alright, what's connecting these two? They want to go in a new direction. Clarify this new direction. There's nostalgia. What do you mean, nostalgia? It has to do with healing the past. I want to go in a new direction, and the memories that we have, I want to heal from those. I want to take off my mask. Why does divine masculine feel like a victim? Because somebody's had to be very patient. Clarify why they feel like a victim, though. Because they recognized what this was, and they intentionally put it on pause. They kept you waiting, and they feel bad about that. What's going to be the outcome here? May I see, please? Outcome here. There's a third party that's going to create a barrier. What are they going to do about that? The answer is going to be yes to a current partner. The answer, a current partner is going to say yes about you being stuck. Clarify what they're going to say yes about. This ending. They want this. They're tired of this too. And they're ready for this to be over. They're going to tell you that, yes, I'm ready for this to be over. Outcome. You're going to not be stuck anymore. You're thinking about how if you end it with this karmic partner, you won't be stuck anymore. And what else will happen? You'll stop numbing. If you're numbing, you'll stop. You'll refocus when it comes to your tribe because there's a lot of dark shit that goes on in your tribe and nobody there has any big dreams. It's like the people you're around are driving you down. What's going to happen between the divine masculine and feminine? You're going to be reinvented. Why is mute here? Because of an injustice. Clarify what you mean. I think you're going to start talking to each other again. You're going to be devoted to one another. You're going to get over this whole karmic situation. Yeah, somebody was trying to silence you. You're going to get over that. Clarify that to be true. Look, there's an observer. It's a soulmate who didn't understand. They were watching, but they didn't understand. They didn't understand. And they don't want you to make an offer either. But I think you're going to. Alright. Is there anything we need to know out of this deck right here? Anything we need to know? Apology about your influences. Anything we need to know about? Anything? Somebody was frozen. Somebody felt like they were better off if they were frozen and not having an infatuation. Alright, how do they feel now? Like they're getting clarity. There's a lot of fantasizing, but they're awakening and they're coming out of their confusion and their despair. Alright, so what's going to be the outcome? There's a secret admirer that's going to stop pretending. They're going to stop showing you any nurturing. And they're going to have a resentment. And how are you going to feel about them? Like you haven't got any more consequences and you can finally get established. No more consequences to getting established. What does that mean exactly? It means that somebody's been hiding the fact that there was a misunderstanding. Clarify the misunderstanding. There was an emotional whirlwind because somebody was drifting and there had to be an apology. Anything else you can tell us? They were like, well, maybe one day, someday, but not now. They were hoping for a new beginning, but somebody didn't want a new beginning. They were drifting. They were rejected. This person rejected this karmic partner. But I don't think they ever told them that. I think now they're finally going to tell them that. Clarify what's going on. They've been avoiding by roaming wild. What are they going to do now? They have a lot of lust. And they've been numbing, like I said. They have a lot of lust for somebody who's beautiful. And they are wanting to go after this, I think. Clarify euphoria. That's all they want is this. They want this person bad. How does the person feel about them? They have a confession to make. And it has to do with tension. What confession would this person make? They would say, I'm not a good person. I'm a shitty individual. You just fell asleep on the phone with me, and I can't love you the way that I want. What would the other person say to them? Thanks for being in my life. It's late, really late. Why aren't you here with me? And I know your fine ass is not single. With, I can't stop thinking of you. Is this love? Alright, Sagittarius. I don't know. I'll be honest with you. I kind of got a little lost at the end right there. But I think it made perfect sense to you. All right, what would spellcasters say to Sagittarius? There's going to be a reconciliation. What would spellcasters say to their divine twin, their twin flame? Love. Family. And home. You're going to have a reconciliation and they are in love. They want to be family and be at home. Their life purpose is here also. What's connecting these two people? Your career. You're supposed to be working together or you are working together. Anything else connecting the two of you? Travel. Passion. And animals. You both love animals. And there's going to be forgiveness. Oh, that's so sweet. Alright. What else, Spirit? Let's go ahead and come out and love your inner goddess real quick. What message do you have for Sagittarius? One card and it's Peonia. This is about your prosperity. It's the healing within is awakening. You're going to have prosperity. And we also got the Water Goddess. We keep getting the same cards for you. Number 27, Peonia. And then number five, the Water Goddess. Alright, so listen carefully. You are now being blessed with prosperity, abundance, and creativity. To enhance this time of joy and amplify your experience of grace, practice gratitude. Simply be happy for what you have and what is being given to you. The universe loves to keep on giving to those who are grateful and happy to receive and who give back to life from a heart with gratitude and a positive attitude. This is such a healing time for you. The healer within is awakening, and your ability to grow and receive healing energy is becoming more powerful. Your soul connection to animals, plants, and crystals will support your healing and increase your energy to attract and create positive life experiences for yourself and others. Are you part woman, part fairy queen? It's that gleam of beautiful brightness, magic, and flirtatious mischief in your eyes. Your soul catches the light. If any person or situation makes you feel less than your stunning true self, then take a moment to affirm the truth of your beauty and magic and your otherworldly charm. Remember that you are a glittering creature with so much to offer. Peonia, the fairy queen of the peony flower, brings you an abundance of beautiful blessings to assist you to fulfill your divine destiny. Meanwhile, renewal after a deep and profound loss, the sweetness of romance, love, and feminine beauty, and special blessing for healing and restoration of the body, mind, and soul. The fairy folk are interested in you. They see that you have the ability for healing, for saving the environment, and awakening higher consciousness in others through art, music, dance, or the way you are with plants, animals, and crystals. In recognition and encouragement of your spiritual purpose and talents, Peonia brings you abundance and prosperity. She brings you happiness and love, and even if your heart truly desires it, fame in your future. Remember, only God knows why. The Earth Mother and her fae creatures are encouraging and supporting you wholeheartedly to find and fulfill your life purpose. The Water Goddess. Very important that you find and fulfill your life purpose, Sagittarius. Have you given another the power to influence your sense of self-worth or your direction in life? Choose with care whom you allow to get close to you and to guide you. It's obvious and yet easy to forget that if we accept guidance or influence from another, we want to make sure that they are living the kind of life and being the kind of person that we aspire to be. Yes, you can learn from and be inspired by others, but you must stay true to yourself. Do not allow anyone else's voice to become more important to you than the divine voice within your own heart. And that includes my voice as well, especially my voice. Your soul has 10,000 flavors. Some people may try to persuade you that one soul flavor is better than the others. Best to ignore those with such unadventurous palates. You are a divine gelateria, or an array of sacred scrumptuousness. Sometimes you will be kind, other times you will be fierce. Sometimes you will be sweet, other times you will be strong and independent, stubborn, and wolf down your lunch like it's the last meal you'll ever eat. Those rare people who accept themselves unconditionally will be able to accept you, all parts of you, unconditionally too. Others who struggle to accept themselves may struggle to accept you. They may want you to behave in a certain way. They may feel embarrassed or afraid of what others may think, and so they try to censor you. Maybe they think they are helping you, but they are not. they aren't quite ready to be freely and truly themselves. Maybe one day they will be. But in the meantime, you won't help them by, or yourself, by trying to change who you are. You are worth so much more, with so much more to offer to those who are ready to embrace all of you. Carefully choose with whom you share yourself. You deserve to be and to be loved for being all of you. Sacred ritual, say aloud with confidence. I trust, love, and respect all the different parts of me to work together as I live my most creative, honest, and beautiful life. I choose to share myself with those who love and respect all of me. All right, Spirit, who are you talking to? C-A-D-A-K-G-F, number 10. T-O-Q-W-O-B-N, number 8. Did that say Boone? Remember Boone? M-I-S-F-C-D-L, 3. D-L-S-F-A-B-F, number 3. V. I-O-10-D-D-R-Y-V. One more time. M-S-W-M-S-M-D, number 11. All right, trinkets, please, Holy Spirit, for this beautiful reading for the sign of Sagittarius. Alright, I have a piece of selenite. I have a key. Somebody needs a key. An elephant. An Archangel Michael. Two palm trees. A dream catcher. A cluster of grapes. A cowboy boot with a horseshoe. A teddy bear with a little baby teddy bear. A little fat elephant. An Eiffel Tower. There's that key with the heart on it again. I have a little girl, little kid, and she looks like she's got on a hat, like a tomboy. I have an EKG with a heart. I have a gasket. I have a horse. It looks like a Mustang. You might drive a Mustang. I have a crescent moon with a heart. I have a crescent moon. I have a leaf for the fall. I have a hand for intuition or a card player. I have a star that looks like a snowflake. And I have that dang engagement ring again. Somebody's going to give you an engagement ring. Or a ring for some reason. Somebody has a ring picked out for you. Alright. I have my bear. A feather. My military pendant. An angel. A maple leaf. A lotus flower. The kundalini. A palm tree. A tramp stamp. Cherries. An arrow, a sailboat, I love you to the moon and back, a music note with a skull, and a rocking horse for a baby. I hadn't seen my pirate in a while. What was I going to do? Get a little to write my book. The Sagittarius need to know anything about their money spirit. What's going on with Sagittarius's money? Sagittarius, you're a counselor, and divine timing is a factor. What do you mean about divine timing? It has to do with your soul tribe. The answer being yes or no. There's something that's undecided, and being a crafter. So you're a counselor, or there is a counselor. Divine timing is here. Your soul tribe, the answer being yes or no, and a crafter. Clarify undecided. It has to do with your past. I cards are going everywhere, Sagittarius. It has to do with your past, a shift, and having options. Clarify the options. Oh, somebody's a rebel or was a rebel, and it's caused them to have a loss. Or you may have lost a rebel. Your options are that a rebel, you're going to have options because of a rebel with a loss. What's going to be the outcome of that? Your spirituality is here. There's a mechanic here. You're manifesting something and they're gossiping about it. With justice on the bottom of the deck. So, let's just see what they're saying. What are they gossiping about when it comes to Sagittarius spirit? Saying that somebody is total drama in action. What's the truth? That Sagittarius is in a private relationship and somebody is brainstorming and trying to figure shit out because of evidence of cheating. What's the truth, spirit? That somebody made bad choices. They took out the trash. Somebody made bad choices with somebody who's trash. They like to go to the gym. Somebody's under spiritual attack because they got caught cheating with somebody they were attracted to like a moth to a flame. And somebody's promiscuous. What else is being said? That you need to chill out because somebody's over and tired of the drama. And Fly has depression, and they're manipulative, and they're a great actor. Anything else we need to know? There's going to be an announcement that the game is over. They used to be a great actor. They're busy, and they are getting played. Alrighty then, let's see how the angels are working here. Angels, how are you working in Sagittarius' life? May I see, please? Sagittarius, your cards are going everywhere, sweetheart. Your purity is here. What else? You need to pray, baby. You have creative power. Something's going to be resurrected, and you're going to have a vision. You're going to see the truth. Clarify what you mean. It's about awakening. Freedom and wisdom with vibes, vibration on the bottom of the deck. Now, I just want to see real quick how our spiritual gifts are operating here. Spiritual gifts for Sagittarius. You're meditating and spirit is promising you something. You may see a rainbow. Somehow rainbows are significant. Anything else? There's something about your house. Okay, what about the house? Spirit. Your chakras are going to be aligned and the mirror is here. So there's somebody who's mirroring you when it comes to being in alignment, and they are involved with your house in some way, and it also involves some travel. Alright, I guess we'll leave it there for now. Anything else you want to say to Sagittarius? Before I close, Spirit, let's get this love who you are. How can Sagittarius love who they are? Oop. Show me how Sagittarius can love who they are, Spirit. You might be selling your house, or somebody might be buying or moving in or renting. Protect your boundaries, Sagittarius, and flock together. Protect your boundaries and flock together. Number 39, protect your boundaries, says this. One of the best ways to love your fabulous self is to set and maintain your boundaries. You'll have way more energy for things that matter, like your own sovereignty, if you quit spending it on situations that drain you. No is a necessary magic word, and it will fuel your enthusiasm when yes shows up. So what if people don't like it or approve of you when you're keeping true to your most sacred bonds and honoring the needs as sacred? Your value doesn't come from outside sources. It doesn't even come from within. You were born with it, and it is immeasurable. Act like it. Protect the sacred space of you. And number 34, flock together. When we gather, we have opportunity to witness and be witnessed. Community strengthens our selfhood and confidence. Seek and celebrate your tribe. If you don't have one, honor the tribe within. There's a multitude of beings inside of you, in shiny, happy parts, the sad, confused, messy parts, the wild and unpredictable parts. Many of them are shunned and disparaged. All deserve a place at your table. When we gather in community or gather all the pieces of ourselves in sacred communion, we forge a bond of unity that helps us to sing the soul home. So you need to flock together with your community or bring all the parts of yourself together in communion and be happy and proud of who you are, even the parts of you that you're not proud of, okay? Okay, now let's see what your best friend would have to say to you, Sagittarius, because I have a feeling that you at least have one of those. What would Sagittarius's best friend say? Demand respect and cry when you want. Demand respect and cry when you want to. It's okay to cry, Sagittarius. It's okay to mourn. It's okay to grieve, baby. Alright, I love you guys, and I hope you enjoyed this reading. Please let me know. You know how to do that. And stay blessed now, okay? Bye-bye.